I became very, very interested in women and girls with ADHD in the mid-90s. It was so clear to me, having worked with many, many families over the years, during the years we thought it was a condition that only affected boys, that those boys had sisters that were struggling too, and those sisters may look different and be affected differently, but they still have ADHD that needed to be diagnosed and treated. Sadly, there were a lot of studies that showed that teachers, for example, didn't know how to recognize ADHD in girls in the classroom, didn't refer those girls for assessment or treatment because those girls weren't driving the teachers crazy the way many of the boys were. Boys were more impulsive, more hyperactive, more likely to argue with a teacher, whereas girls were more quiet, worked much harder to keep the teacher from becoming mad at them, and so they went under the radar for years. I've also worked with so many mothers that clearly were struggling with ADHD, so I set out on a mission with my longtime partner, Patricia Quinn, an MD who's also specialized in treating ADHD, and together with Dr. Ellen Lippman, we wrote books, Understanding Girls with ADHD, and then later Understanding Women with ADHD. These were groundbreaking books. And initially, there was a lot of pushback. A lot of researchers still believed it was a primarily male disorder. I'm very proud that in the succeeding 25 years, there's really a growing consensus that ADHD is kind of an equal opportunity disorder. And not only that, but that ADHD in females is a very serious disorder if it's not treated. Research has come out of Scandinavia showing that there's a high likelihood of psychiatric hospitalization among women in their 20s with untreated ADHD along with coexisting conditions. There are all kinds of risk factors when we don't treat our daughters, when mothers aren't treated. I always say to moms, just like when you get on the airline and they say, put on your oxygen mask first, I say, let's get your ADHD treated. You'll be a much more effective mom, and you'll be able to teach your children with ADHD what you know about how to manage ADHD. It's really a family condition, and we want to support women and their daughters to get the help that they need. It's always been my vision to have a special division for women and girls. And I'm so excited that I have Dr. Nadeau, who's joined our center with a passionate interest in treating women and girls as well. So we're in the process now of developing a whole set of services specifically targeted on the needs of women and girls with ADHD. One of those issues that doesn't get talked about much at all in most ADHD centers is the enormous impact of hormonal fluctuation on girls and women. One thing we do know is that girls are often likely to be diagnosed with ADHD as they go through puberty. There's a reason for that. Hormonal fluctuations with the menstrual cycle start making their ADHD symptoms much more impactful. That continues on through a female's life. Pregnancy issues, perimenopausal issues, menopausal issues, and we are excited to be partnering with a specialist in women's hormonal issues, Dr. Rachel Rubin, so that we can offer really comprehensive care for women and girls with ADHD to help them live happy, productive lives and not struggle so long.